تثني الحسن أحدا. Imam Hassan Basri rahmahullah ta'ala, he did not exclude any of the Sahaba from his statement. Anna Sahabata kanu yaf'aluna dhalika. That the Sahaba, they would do that. They would perform raf'ul yadayn. He did not exclude anybody, any of the Sahaba of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam from his statement. As if it is the ijma of the Sahaba alayhim ridwan. And likewise, again, Imam Ali bin Madini rahmahullah ta'ala, he said that haq على المسلمين. This is again Imam Bukhari in his Juzur رفع اليدين. حق على المسلمين أن يرفعوا أيديهم عند الركوع والرفع منه لحديث ابن عمر هذا. Imam Ali bin Abdullah al-Madini, he said that it is the duty, it is the responsibility, the haq, it is the right of the Muslims at large that they lift their hands before ruku' and after ruku' لِحَدِيثِ ibn Umar هَذَا, because of the, due to the hadith of Sayyidina Abdullah bin Umar, this one of which we have recited, which is mentioned in Sahih Bukhari and in Sahih Muslim. And a taifa, a group of the Ahnaf, they said that number one, this raf'ul yadayn, it is a bid'ah, it is a bid'ah, it is an innovation. And Imam Bukhari made a radd on them when he said, وَمَنْ زَعَمَ أَنَّهُ بِدْعَى فَقَدْ طَعَنَ فِي الصَّحَابَةِ. Whoever it is that claims that رَفْعُ الْيَدَيْنِ is an innovation, as one taifa of the Ahnaf they did, they claim that it is an innovation, فَقَدْ طَعَنَ فِي الصَّحَابَةِ, then such a person, they have accused the Sahaba at large. They have made a ta'an, a slander upon the Sahaba of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because there is no proof from any of the Sahaba. The hadith of Sayyidina Jabir bin Samura, the hadith of Sayyidina Abdullah bin Mas'ud, the hadith of Sayyidina Abdullah bin Umar, we'll discuss next week and we'll show how it is not proven from any of them, alayhim ridwan. And we'll finish today with the statement of Imam Abu Bakr. Abu Bakr al-Marwazi. Abu Bakr al-Marwazi, Muhammad ibn Nasr al-Marwazi, where he says that ajma'a alayhi ulama'u al-amsar, that this raf' al-yadayn ajma'a alayhi ulama'u al-amsar. And Imam Abu Bakr, Muhammad ibn Nasr al-Marwazi, he was from the great travelers who he traveled throughout all of the Muslim lands, from Egypt, Sham, Hijaz, everywhere he went, Yemen, all of the Muslim lands, he traveled all of them. And he said, أَجْمَعَ عَلَيْهِ عُلَمَاءُ الْأَمْصَارِ إِلَّا أَهْلُ الْكُوفَةِ. All of the ulama in all of the lands, all of them collectively, they have agreed upon it and they have consensus upon it, except for one people, except for one group of people, who were the people of Kufa, the people of Iraq, the madrasa of Imam Abu Hanifa rahimahullah. And alhamdulillah, we have adl and we have insaf. When we mention the name of Imam Abu Hanifa, what do we say? Rahimahullah. When we mention the name of Imam Muhammad bin Hassan Shaybani, we say rahimahullah ta'ala, rahmatan wasi'a. We do not have ta'assub, we do not have such fanaticism that we cannot listen to what the other group is saying. Yes, we listen. And we analyze the adilla and the barahin the way our muhaddithun understood, the way our aslaf, the way our mutaqaddimin, the way the muhaddithun alayhim ridwan, the way they interpreted and the way they sifted between these masail, that is aslamu turuq. That is the most safe of all of the ways to go, the way of the muhaddithun alayhim ridwan. So only the people of Kufa, they rejected and they made inkar on the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam. So whoever is that does not act upon this, do we say their salah is batil? La, we do not say their salah is batila. Who are we to say their salah is batila? But do we say their salah is deficient? Yes, we say their salah is deficient. Do we say their salah is lacking from a sunnah of the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam? Then we say yes. And that is extremely clear. That is more clear than the sun fi nisfin nahar, in the middle of the day. The way the sun is in the middle of the day, clear, everybody, there is nothing to doubt it. Then the same way, this is from the sunan of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that he lifted his hands before ruku' and after ruku', and when he stood from two rak'ahs for his third rak'ah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded us to follow him alayhi salatu wa sallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded us, لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنًا. There was for you, there is for you, in the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the most beautiful pattern of ways to follow, the most ideal of role models to follow is that of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In our qubur, we'll be asked about him, ماذا تقول في هذا الرجل الذي بعث فيكم. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will question us on يوم القيامة, ماذا أجبتم المرسلين. What is it? How is it that you answered the call of the messengers عليهم الصلاة والسلام? Not of fulan and fulan. From Banu Adam, كُلُّ بَنِي آدَمْ خَطَّاءَ وَخَيْرُ الْخَطَّائِينَ التَّوَّابُونَ. Only the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that is what is binding upon us. That is what is binding upon us to follow, is the way that we have been taught by our Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So next week, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala, we'll analyze some of the adilla of the mukhalifin, analyze some of the evidences that they use. There are many evidences, but there are a couple, four or five that they use, which are very common. So we'll take a jaiza, an analysis of those adilla, and how we'll prove that they are all unproven from whoever they lead up to. Wa sallallahu ta'ala ala khayri khalqihi Muhammadin wa alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Wa salamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Shaykh, Imam Nawawi, rahimahullah, he mentioned that so many sahabas used to make rafa, and it's, he mentioned as well that there is some of Sahaba that he made Rafa.
Yeah, we'll discuss them next week, inshallah. Yeah, al-asbu al-qadim, inshallah, nantahaddath an dhalika, inshallah.
Barakallahu feek.
Wa feekum, barakallahu.